In Module 2, I'll show you how to use the Advisor portal and how to reap benefits of all the features that are available there. To begin with, I'd like you to understand that alerts appear when a workload is unpatched, misconfigured, when it's risking data loss, or when you've reached an unsupported state. And these alerts will appear for each of the issues that Advisor identifies and will have a matching KB article where you can read the solution. Another of the key features in the Advisor portal are configuration snapshot and history. The snapshot contains the latest configuration information for each of the servers that are monitored. The history will highlight the changes and will show you when a change occurred, on what property, what was the previous value, and what is the current value. And finally, this feature will give you the common settings needed to diagnose a problem, which you can easily copy and share with Microsoft support. So now I'll move on to the demo, where I'll show you the portal at systemcenteradvisor.com. Now we're here at systemcenteradvisor.com, and as you can see, we show you what workloads are available, a preview of the portal, and different ways to go into the portal. I'm going to go ahead and sign in with an existing account, but first I'd like to show you one of the most recent changes we've made after several users provided us their feedback. Now we don't require a Microsoft account to log into System Center Advisor. You can also use your organizational account on Advisor. For this demo, I'll use my Microsoft account, and I'm going to go ahead and log in. And now I will be taken into the Advisor overview page, where I will get an at-a-glance view at all the information that Advisor has collected in my environment. I'm currently using my Contoso demo account, and as you can see, the first thing that's popped out to me is that there are servers with critical alerts and servers with warning alerts. You can also see the breakdown of alerts by area, just in case a particular workload has higher priority for you than another. Further down below, we can see the 5 most recent alerts that have appeared. And further down on the Advisor page, you can see the most recent activities and the server status. Underneath most recent activities, you will see the problems that Advisor detected in the last 24 hours, how many configuration changes it has detected in the last week, and how many rules Advisor found applicable to your environment and verified. So out of those 313 rules, Advisor found 37 problems. Under my reporting agents, I have 4 that appear to be reporting correctly and none that are reporting incorrectly. So next, I'm going to go further down into the alerts view, where I will get all of the alerts that Advisor has surfaced, and I will get detail on each one of these alerts. You can see that I have alerts grouped by severity. I have one that is an error, and it appears that one of my servers is configured incorrectly, and Advisor cannot give me all the proper information on it. I can immediately go down into this knowledge base article and find out what are the settings that that server has that need to be changed. And this is a KB article that was created by our CSS support team, and each one of the alerts that you see below has a corresponding KB article. You can see there are alerts for servers without backups, SQL Server databases without a clean consistency check, and missing updates on servers. Now, alerts can be ignored if they are very low priority or if you think they don't apply to your environment. So if I select a particular alert, I can click Ignore. And then Advisor will ask me if I want to ignore only that alert or if I want to ignore all alerts based on this problem for this particular server or for all my servers. I'm going to go ahead and select the first option and click OK. And now that alert has disappeared from my view. If at any point I change my mind and I want to get that alert back, I can go into Manage Alert Rules, find the ignored alert there, and stop ignoring it. Now, one of the very valuable features that Advisor has is that it can show you all the possible rules that Advisor can check. And these are grouped by workload and components. If ever you want to ignore a rule, you can also uncheck it here and apply. There is much more to see within the alerts view, so I recommend you explore this and experiment with all the valuable information that Advisor can give you on the alerts. You can also move further down into configuration and view the configuration snapshot for each one of your servers. You'll see that it's again grouped by workload, so we can look at what properties are applicable to each workload and what are the values that are set for that particular property. If I'm curious about changes that have happened in my configuration, I can go into Change History, select a server, and view the property that has changed with this previous and current value. Since this is a new environment, most of my settings have changed, so it has detected plenty of changes in my servers. Further down, we can go into the server section, and we can see all the agents, gateways, and operation manager management groups that are reporting to this particular account. You can also see the reporting status for each one of these servers, and when was the last time that they sent an update to Advisor. You can also remove items from this by selecting and clicking the Remove button. Finally, you can go into the Account section, where you can view your account ID and update your account name or your first or last name. If you also want to use the organizational account, you can go further down into Add Organization and add your own organization ID. And if you wish, you can also close your account from this screen. And that wraps up the demo for the Advisor portal. This is all just a small sampling of all the features that you can explore here, so I recommend you go in and take a look.